remember a man from England named Thomas Bray, B-R-O-A-Y, like the braying of a donkey. Only he might have brayed, but he got a lot of things done. He spent his entire life working to improve life for the poor and the outcast people. He began with the poor children and adults around him in Birmingham, England, and then later in London, providing Christian education material for them to read as they were learning how to read. Later, he expanded his concern about people who needed help to include prisoners in the English prison system. Again, providing reading materials, raising funds to help them get back on their feet. And also the same thing with English sailors, these men who were out to sea for months, away from family, away from civilization. And 50 years, a half century before Thomas Jefferson wrote the Declaration of Independence, Thomas Bray founded an organization to educate and to evangelize Native Americans here on this continent and enslaved Africans. He had come over here and spent only 10 weeks. He originally came here because he wanted to help educate the clergy and the people in the emerging Anglican churches. And he did that. He went back and founded what we might call the first lending library system. But he also became impassioned for the plight of the Native Americans and the enslaved Africans. The other thing I think is noteworthy about Thomas Bray, which kind of gets closer to home here, is that some historians believe that his work inspired this man named General James Oglethorpe to envision an English colony in this new world so that men who are getting out of debtor's prison could come over here and have a new start in the colony of Georgia. Thomas Bray, treating people right. And then of course, just 7 weeks ago, the world lost Desmond Tutu, another Anglican priest who knew firsthand the ongoing tragedy of governments not treating people right. He lived in South Africa, as we know, under the oppression and sometimes the violence of apartheid. Here's people living in their own land, overtaken by European white people, which sounds familiar, doesn't it, here in our continent. And then they treated the local folks like they were leftovers, like they were in the way, except maybe do menial work. Tutu had begun his career not as a priest, but as a school teacher. But the government, again, the white government, took it over because they didn't want the black kids to get a good education, because that meant they could maybe move up in society. So they took them over, and Tutu quit in disgust. So he went through some training, he became a priest, he even studied in England for 2 years, and his family was with him, and they came back, and he became a leader in the fight against apartheid. The crazy thing was that he got criticized from both sides. Of course, the white establishment criticized him because he was trying to change things. They even pulled his passport one time so he couldn't go overseas and tell the rest of the world about the madness in South Africa. And some of the African people got angry with him because he wasn't working fast enough, which is the same poor logic that assassinated Gandhi a generation before. Some radical Hindu, well, you're not working fast enough, shot him in that crowd. But as you probably remember, he was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize in 1984. Treating people right is at the heart of our faith. You and I will never have the influence that they had, but we have a mission, all of us, to be aware of the people around us, and with God's help and God's wisdom and God's strength, to treat them right. As today's psalm says, our delight is in the law of the Lord. That law of love guides us and strengthens us. And so,
bear the authority of government in this and every land, that they may be led to wise decisions and right actions for the welfare and peace of the world. Open, O Lord, the eyes of all people to behold thy gracious hand in all thy works, that, rejoicing in thy whole creation, they may honor thee with their substance and be faithful stewards of thy bounty. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. We pray also at this time in our diocesan cycle of prayer for the Church of St. Martin's in Chattanooga, St. Martin's Preschool in Chattanooga, and St. James in Enemy Swim, South Dakota. We also pray for the request of our congregation for Joy Sandifer, Eddie, Barbara, Amber, Chris and Marshall, and David Redheffer. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to grant us grace so to follow the good examples of all thy saints, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant these our prayers, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen.
Let us turn to page 331 in the Book of Common Prayer, and let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against thee in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved thee with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of thy Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in thy will and walk in thy ways, to the glory of thy name. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy have promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Hear the word of God to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail or are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the perfect offering for our sins, and not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Welcome again this morning. Glad to see you guys. Just a couple of things. Seems like every week there's always just a couple of things. This coming Saturday is our food pantry. You're welcome to come help us out. We've been helping between 35 and 40 people a week. If you feel so led, any donations toward this effort would be more than welcome. Also, our vestry will be meeting next Sunday. Ask you to be in prayer for us as we continue to try to provide leadership. And we're also looking for some more applications to come in for our search team. So keep in prayer for those people too. Anything else you can think of? Thank you all.
Offer to God the sacrifice of thanksgiving. Bring your offerings and come into his courts. death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory that is precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make. Having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and his glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy mighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son Jesus Christ and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present to thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, who takest away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather of the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him, and in he in us. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.